Boom! What's up? Mudwata here, Guyanese contologist. Usually, I would mind my own business. That is business taking place in Guyana and the Caribbean. But not today. We live in an outrage age where everyone is outraged about something or the other. Some people are outraged about Donald Trump, some about the race of the actor playing James Bond, some people are outraged at their neighbor's cat for barking. Now you are outraged that I just said cats bark. I'm astonished at some of the stupid stunt that outrages people. But you know what I'm outraged about? People not standing up for their beliefs and moral values anymore. All who know Kevin Hart, press the like button.
One of my biggest fears is my son growing up and being gay. That's a fear.
Right. A popular black American comedian slash actor slash producer who grew up in Philadelphia and got a career breakthrough when he was cast in a TV show series called Undeclared. Hart quickly became one of the most iconic comedians in the world and is also no stranger to Hollywood. So, in early December, the organizers of the Oscar Awards announced Kevin Hart will be hosting this year's award. I was proud of my boy Kevin, and in less than 24 hours after that announcement, guess what? Of course, outrage. This time it was about homophobic things that Hart has said in the past.
Concern and outrage on Twitter, on Facebook, on other social networks about homophobic things that he's posted in the past.
It is abundantly clear what Hart's views are when it comes to the LGBT, the rest of the alphabet community, from his social media posts and comedy writings.
And a little boy was grinding on my son's ass. He was like this. I didn't know what to do. I panicked. I knocked them both down.
He, just like me, takes exception to this whole batty culture. So poor Kevin Hart buckled to the pressure of these anti-man internet trolls and decided to step down from hosting the Oscar. Something that he said he has dreamed of all his life. Hart announced his decision via Twitter and said, and I quote, "I have made a choice to step down from hosting this year's Oscar. This is because I do not want to be a distraction on a night that should be celebrated by so many amazing, talented artists. I sincerely apologize to the LGBTQ community for my insensitive words from my past." End quote. He also went on to say, and I quote, "I am sorry that I hurt people. I'm evolving and I want to continue to do so. My goal is to bring people together and not tear us apart. Much love and appreciation to the Academy. I hope we meet again." End quote. Now, one of the comments that caused this outrage was Kevin Hart saying,
"Keep in mind, I'm not homophobic. I have nothing against gay people. Be happy. Do what you want to do. But me being a heterosexual male, if I can prevent my son from being gay, I will."
Kevin. You should not have to apologize for the way you feel about these mentally ill people who have infected our society like a cancer and are corrupting our children before they can even make proper sense of their purpose in this life. As a fan from all the way across the globe, I urge you to not let these people prevent you from achieving something you've dreamed of all your life.
So I just got a call from the Academy, and that call basically said, "Kevin, apologize for your tweets of old, or we're going to have to move on and find another host." Talking about the tweets from 2009-2010. I chose to pass. I passed on the apology. The reason why I passed is because I've addressed this several times. This is not the first time this has come up. I've addressed it. I've spoken on it. I've said where the rights and wrongs were. I've said who I am now versus who I was then. I've done it. I'm not going to continue to go back and tap into the days of old when I moved on and I'm in a completely different space in my life. The same energy that went into finding those old tweets could be the same energy put into finding the response to the questions that have been asked years after years after years. We feed in the internet trolls and we reward them. I'm not gonna do it, man. I'm gonna be me. I'm gonna stay in my grind. Regardless, Academy, I'm thankful and appreciative of the opportunity. If it goes away, no harm, no foul.
Go host your Oscars and shine like a star. Don't let them bully you. By the way, I have it on good authority that Trevor Noah from The Daily Show is a low-key anti-man. Is this true? Comment and let me know if you believe so too. Mudwata, boom up!
Hold up.